Hello and welcome everybody. I hope you're having a great day. The story of the creation. I have always wondered about the story of the creation since I was a child. And the more I grow up in the age, the more I realize that the people who created this story have a low IQ and they don't think about the paradox and the myth they put themselves into. There are a variant between Islamic narrative to the story of the creation and the Old Testament narrative, but here I am interested in the Islamic narrative to the story. So it's said that in the beginning God was alone and nothing existed before him. And then he decided to create the pen so he can write in the dhikr. The dhikr here means the book of the creation. The thing I don't understand here is, if God was the only object that existed before, then where the pen and the book called dhikr came from? Is it apart from his body or from something else? And even if they were created from nothing, this pen and this book, they should be in a space with Allah, and this space should be bigger than Allah. They have to be separated from Allah. All of this does not make sense, neither the creation of the paradise and the hell. Why do you create human beings if you know they will make sins? And why do you punish them if they are following your script? After that, Allah created the seven heaven in 2 days, and he spent 4 days in the creation of the earth, as he said in chapter 41 verse 10. He placed on the earth fair mountain standing high, showered his blessing upon it, and ordained all its mean of substance, totaling 4 days exactly for all who ask. And the last thing he decided to do after he finished is to create a human being called Adam. But he forget, in order to assure the survival of this new creature, he need to have a female, so he decide to take a piece from Adam and create Eve. As explained in the chapter 23 verse 12, and indeed we created humankind from an existence of clay. Chapter 3 verse 59 said as well, indeed the example of Jesus in the sight of Allah is like that of Adam. He created him from dust, then said to him, be, and he was. But the question here is, why you need to do that? Why can't you just create Eve from another piece of clay, or create more copies than two or one? This mistake that Allah made in the beginning of the creation of mankind that led to Cain to kill his brother, because he was jealous of his marrying the beautiful of the two sisters. When Cain killed Abel, then there is only one male left. So how does this reproduction work if you only have one brother and two sisters? According to the Islamic narrative, Cain was older than Abel. And one day God decided to ask them for sacrifice. There are too many interpretations on why this sacrifice for, but let us recall here a summary of what was said by early Imams in it. Several scholars among the Salaf and the later generations said that Allah allowed Adam to marry his daughters to his sons. Because of the necessity of such action, they also said that in every pregnancy, Adam was given a twin, a male and a female, and he used to give the female for one twin to the male of the other twin in marriage. Abel's sister was not beautiful, while Cain's sister was beautiful, resulting in Cain wanting her for himself. So they said that Eve gave birth to two twins each pregnancy, a female and a male. But this does not exist in the Old Testament or the Torah that exists before the Quran. Neither the Quran himself has the description of Adam's family and how many children he has. We only have interpretation and many conflicting stories that does not make sense, and Allah could solve this problem by making a short chapter and call it chapter of Adam and Eve to explain, but he chose to keep silence. Rather, it seems that the writer of the Quran does not understand what's happening. Like someone who go to the cinema and watch half of the movie before the lights cut off and was forced to finish the story from his imagination. So in order for Adam to solve this issue, he told them to go and make sacrifice to Allah. Cain was a farmer and Abel was a shepherd, and he used to own sheep and cows and animals. Where do they came from and how are these animals domesticated? Nobody knows how he make artificial selection in 2 days to be a shepherd. So what happened after is Cain took some of his grain as a sacrifice and Abel took his best animal he has. So Allah now who is going to decide which sacrifice he going to accept. He sees the grain and he does not like it, and because he liked the blood and the killing, he chose the sacrifice of Abel over the offering of Cain. Cain got angry and Satan came to him and told him to kill his brother, so he killed him. From here we are going to fall into a lot of technical problems with this story. In the Old Testament, God get angry about Cain, but yet he knew this was going to happen. In the chapter 5 verse 31, the writer of the Quran said, "Then Allah sent a crow digging a grave in the ground for a dead crow in order to show him how to bury the corpse of his brother. He cried, 'Have I ever failed to be like the crow and bury the corpse of my brother?' So he became regretful." The Old Testament narrates that Allah punished Cain for his mistake and make his land not suitable for cultivation. He became wandering on the earth because he was scared of somebody to kill him. And God told him, "You have nothing to be afraid of, and who hurt you, I will punish him." Where do people who want to kill him came from? Is there another Adam created by Allah? All of this does not make sense. And even if we accept somehow that this makes sense, this said as well that Cain met his wife and he made her pregnant and they have a baby called Enoch. So where did this woman came from? Nobody knows. So when Muslim hear this, the best option he have is that Cain married his sister. It's like it's okay and we have no problem with that. The conclusion here is the writer of the Quran seem lost in the translation and does not have proper understanding of the story of the beginning that was stolen from the Old Testament, and the Old Testament itself was taking this story from the ancient civilization like the Babylonians and the Egyptians. Thank you guys very much for watching and see you again.